65, a 7-1 junior from Santa Cruz, California, Tim Young. At center for Kentucky, number 13, a 6'10 junior from Chicago, Illinois, Nazi Muhammad. At a guard for Stanford, number 3, a 6'3 junior from Kansas City, Kansas, Chris Weems. At a guard for Kentucky, number 5, a 6'2 junior from Boston, Massachusetts, Wayne Turner. At a guard for Stanford, number 11, a 6-foot junior from Los Angeles, California, Arthur Lee. And at a guard for Kentucky, number 15, a 6'3 junior from Peachtree City, Georgia, Jeff Shepard. And introducing the head coaches for Stanford, Mike Montgomery in his 20th season. For Kentucky, Tubby Smith in his first season.
Their records are almost identical. Tubby Smith's team, 33-4, the number 2 seed out of the South. And Stanford, 30-4, coming out as the number 3 seed from the Midwest. Billy, let's talk about the Packer points for this game.
Well, Jim, a lot of things going on the line right here, but we'll take a look at them. First of all, let's talk about Cardinal sins. They have to be very careful early in this ballgame not to turn the ball over. They've got a nice assist-turnover ratio on the season. Can they handle Kentucky's pressure? There's been a missing link for Stanford. It's Chris Weems, only shooting 2-for-12 of 3. This is a fella that is capable of having big scoring games. He hasn't done it in the NCAA tournament. Has to come up big today. The human erasers, Kentucky, have the best shot-blocking twosome in college basketball. This is something that Stanford likes to go inside, but can they handle that great shot blocking of Kentucky? In the four-man matchup, Padgett going up against Madsen. Both are playing very well in the NCAA tournament. Could be the key statistical matchup in this ballgame. Jimmy, I'd like to say one other thing. Watching these two teams come out for the starting lineups, nobody from Stanford has ever been in this position before. You know, they can't think of a former teammate that's been in this position. So Kentucky has a huge advantage early in this ballgame, having been there before with some of these very same players.
Well, they have Bill Cowden in the stands, the only living starter from the 1942 team flown here by the school. Stanford in the red, Kentucky white. Tim Higgins, Bob Donato, Larry Rose draw the plum assignment here to officiate national semifinal number 1.
And normally, Jim, if that lack of experience is going to show, it's going to show in the first 3 or 4 minutes of a ball game.
Jeff Shepard retrieves for Kentucky. Here's Wayne Turner, so hot at the postseason, MVP of the SEC tournament and of the South Regional.
And Jim, remember how well he played in the NCAA tournament last year as well. Very seasoned veteran at the point guard spot.
Allen Edwards between two defenders, and Pete Sauer pulls it down. Sauer was a question mark with a knee injury till just before game time. A couple of hours ago, got the green light. There's Weems. First shot bounces away too strong.
No, but I like the release. You like a guy who hasn't been shooting well to be long on his first shot, not short.
Tough pass. Sauer secures it for Stanford.
Young is a big presence in there at 7 foot.
Lob it in to Madsen, and Padgett had him on the back. So lead to Mark Madsen, the Mad Dog.
Madsen has been outstanding, Jim, in this tournament so far. 16-17 against the College of Charleston, 19-10 against Western Michigan, 15-13 against Purdue. Every game he's been solid.
Calling for it again. Padgett manning on him.
So far, you have to like the fact that Stanford's turning this into a half-court game.
Lee, Arthur Lee, drills a three to open the scoring in San Antonio.
Picks up right where Jim Herrick saw him in the Rhode Island game. Man is on fire.
What a stretch he had to bring him back. 11 down, the late going. 6 down with a minute to go, in fact.
Straight man-to-man here, and Young on Nazi Muhammad is one of the few guys that Nazi has seen that can really overpower him inside.
Edwards in the lane,
up
over
shot.
Young, and all Stanford around that rebound.
Good block out by Sauer that time to keep Nazi Muhammad off the boards.
Lee penetrates, tripped by Turner.
Now Turner feels that Lee's foot got entwined with his and that he didn't do anything to commit the foul. But obviously you're going to see right here that the foot comes in. Unfortunate foul for Turner. Straight man-to-man out of bounds for Kentucky. Dangerous pass. Boy, if you're Mike Montgomery, you want to get Weems off somehow.
Another Kentucky foul. This in the act of shooting. And this will send Lee to the line. It's called on Nazi Muhammad. We talked about earlier the Kentucky starters, how they've shot during this NCAA tournament. All over 50%.
Jim, as a team, they shot 48% on the year. And as a team, they're shooting 53-6 in the NCAA tournament.
I like the way... Go ahead, Billy.
That's why they're being out-rebounded as a team, yeah. Because they're not missing any shots.
I like the way this guy's shooting, by the way, from the line in the tournament. Hasn't missed. Now 28 of 28.
Right, and that coming in also makes that 31 straight free throws.
Kentucky's fourth possession, yet to score.
Nice job by Weems getting out on Shepherd, a red-hot player for Kentucky who's matched up pretty well size-wise. Normally he has an advantage.
Padgett on the wing, that three short. And again, Stanford has the box-out position underneath.
Well, if you're Mike Montgomery, you realize your guys did not come out cold.
Arthur Lee, all eight for Stanford.
I say we're going to see, oh, Jim, I didn't even see Evans hiding over in the sidelines. I was just ready to say we're going to see Evans early in this game, and there he is already to come in.
Ooh, Muhammad almost had a three-point opportunity. He'll shoot two.
I looked down at the bench to say, okay, when's Tubby going to go down to find Evans? I couldn't find him, and then I looked, and he was already over there. We this year were really fortunate. We had Stanford in some of their best moments when they beat UCLA and were still undefeated up at their home arena. And then we had them in probably their lowest moment, Jim, when they had to go all the way across country against a quick team in Connecticut.
The man in the middle for Kentucky, Nazi Muhammad, starred in the win over UCLA with six blocks and really set the pace for that in the opening minutes. Bruins didn't have a chance. They were undermanned that game. Muhammad with one more. Foul on Young. His first. So Evans in for Kentucky.
And Kentucky with the hit has a chance to do something which should be their advantage today, and that is full court press. Try to get the ball out of Lee's hands if they can.
Weems.
Tough shot, huh?
Way too hard off the glass, and there's Evans coming in for the rebound.
It's hard to believe that Weems is shooting so poorly. Great elevation by Shepherd.
Jeff Shepherd's first, well, Kentucky's first basket comes from Shepherd. 8-3, Stanford.
Nice job by Lee to wave Sauer away to give some open court area for his dribble. Looking to hit Madsen down low. He's got Evans on him. He's got a little bit of size there.
Weems, again, in traffic, tipped around a couple of times, and Evans with his second board.
Evans really sets a new tempo for Kentucky when he comes in the ballgame. Can push the ball up the floor. Really kind of gives them three guards out there.
They've got Madsen on Muhammad underneath. Shepherd with a three. Madsen. Muhammad right over him. And there's Sauer boxing out on Edwards.
Yeah, Sauer has got too much power for Edwards. Edwards is going to have to make him run, particularly on that bad knee.
Here's Wink's favorite shot, and he hits it for a three.
Boy, you gotta like that, Jim. Young man not shooting well, but still taking shots. Great sign for Stanford.
That's where he's effective. Catch and shoot, put it on the floor, and he usually doesn't score. 11-3, Cardinals.
Good inside screen allows Nazi Muhammad to get a very easy shot.
Billy, I'm impressed, by the way. Stanford's just
blocking out, aren't they?
Blocking out, has all the position inside on the rebound. Young. And this could be Muhammad's second.
Now that means McGlure, who's already over there, has to get in. It's very interesting how Tubby Smith uses these two big guys, averaging right at about 20 minutes a game each.
That is the second on Muhammad. McGlure will replace him along with Saul Smith. But we go to the first break. Arthur Lee with eight, and Stanford strikes first. For longest duration between Final Four appearances.
Well, you know what? That was kind of a silly trivia question for many years until they got in 89. They had a 3-0 record in NCAA play. They had never lost a game from 42 to 89.
Once they finally got in, they went in as a high seed in the tournament. They lost to Siena.
That's
after
right.
A 47-year absence in the first round. It was a
14 seed.
and lose to a three.
Yep.
Stanford 11-3 lead. They've brought in David Mosley, number 21, but it's Lee again this time. And going the other way.
Push off on the inside. We have Smith in the ball game now, replacing Turner as well. McGlure down inside, and here's with McGlure in the game. He's used primarily as a screener, step-out man. They'll look for other people to score, Shepard being one of them.
Saul Smith, freshman, son of head coach Tubby Smith, and it's his birthday today. Young Saul, 19. Shepard fires the three, and again, all Stanford clearing the board.
Jim, you notice one thing that Kentucky is getting one and done. No second chance points whatsoever off the glass. That's not something that's going to work very well for Tubby Smith. I'd expect Padgett to get back in that ball game pretty soon because he's a pretty good offensive rebounder, and he needs some help there.
Young working on McGlure, got the basket. 10-point lead for Stanford.
Step in move. Now let's think about Kentucky. They were only down, they were down 38-20 to Duke in the first half. That was the first time they've been behind anybody since Alabama and the SEC, where they were down 54-53. So this is a team of runs, not accustomed to being behind, though.
Maybe that will start one. 2-point basket by Evans.
Good job by Evans to recognize he's got Mattson on him, so he uses his quickness, taking him outside. Mosley that time. Smith could have come back with a little double team trap and had the ball out of Lee's hands.
Sauer cutting through. Waits and scores.
His knee didn't look bad on that one. Terrific catch by Sauer in the put away. The young man from Pittsburgh.
Captain of the Cardinal. 15-5 Stanford.
You can see that Stanford well scouting here.
Shepard, great pass, gave it up at the last moment to Edwards, and a possible three-point play.
McGlure doing good screening on the outside. That time Stanford didn't fight over the top.
Shepard
screening outside to step it up. Shepard with a good hit inside, and Edwards with the put away.
Mills comes in, Cameron Mills for Jeff Shepard. And Edwards has a chance for the three-point play. That whistle on Sauer, his first. Shepard went to the bench. Shepard and Edwards, the only two players who saw game action in Kentucky's national championship victory 2 years ago over Syracuse.
You know, Jim, you get the feeling right here that Tubby Smith is playing this game to try to wear Stanford down because he's going to this bench often early, which he often does, but you get a feeling he's got a lot of confidence as to where this game's going, even though he's behind at the time. But he's got to remember, Stanford's a very deep team as well, particularly down inside.
Stanford just made another sub. Brian Mendez, number 32. Their best three-point shooter has entered the game, and he's a native Texan. Young takes the jumper. Tipped out to Smith. Got a man ahead. It's Evans. Perfect pass. Hit Evans to Burks.
How about Evans on that concentration, watching it right into his hands. I said he's the most explosive guy coming off the bench in this Final Four. He offers so much.
Young, too strong, and McGlure just pulls it out of the air. So Kentucky on a run, five unanswered, looking for more.
Young not with quick offensive post moves, so it's a little easier for Kentucky to get balance on the boards when he shoots.
McGlure wants to challenge him.
Hey! Left-handed hook. Showing the left-hander how to play. McGlure showing more quickness than Young.
15-12, seven unanswered.
We talk about these great runs that Kentucky has been on in this tournament. Mattson, he fouled, offensive foul with the elbow.
Mattson and Padgett is hurt.
Here we'll see McGlure kind of surprise Young with his quickness. A little drop step, puts it down, and goes underneath those long arms, the left-handed hook. We'll see Mattson right here. We talk about Mad Dog. He drops Padgett to the floor.
That offensive foul counts as a team turnover for Stanford. It's the first turnover in the last 21 minutes plus in the tournament. When you go back to the end stretch of the Rhode Island game, pretty remarkable.
Again, that hit putting a man on the floor, Pernell Whitaker and Cedric Chavez fought in here a couple of years ago, so that's the closest thing to a knockout we've seen.
Cameron Mills inching Kentucky closer.
And Mills, who's made the shot against Duke, his first basket of the NCAA tournament, hits another. Good dish.
Mendez, top of the key, three.
Too quick a shot. Boy, are they getting a tremendous job by McGlure since he's come in to replace Nazi Muhammad.
And Young hit with his second. So two on Muhammad, two on Young. And we go to the second break with Kentucky, 9 unanswered to move within one. He started 1 of 8 from the field, but has now hit its last 5 field goals. Trying to make the championship game, in fact, for the third straight year. That last foul was not on Young. Let's correct that. They charged it, in fact, to Mosley. So Young with one, Mosley with one.
And, Jim, they almost had a chance to talk about Kentucky in regard to streaks being a number one seed for 4 years in a row. This year coming in as a number two.
Yeah, no one's ever done that.
Here we see, right, we see Young down inside with McGlure. McGlure starting to get a lot of confidence down there, wanting the basketball. Good defense by Weems on Shepard. That's a good matchup.
Shepard.
Illegal screen.
Yep, it's going to be called on Cameron Mills.
And give a lot of credit right there to Weems. I said he has a good matchup for Shepard. He's fighting over screens. Mills couldn't stop him. But it gives Kentucky, with this little break in action, a chance to set their press up again. Straight man-to-man press. Obviously, Stanford trying to get the ball in Weems' hands with Lee out of the ball game.
A pass, but a foul from behind. Jaron Collins caught it.
Bad foul that time. You've got a quicker, smaller man following a big man coming to the ball.
Second quick one on Mills, who will sit. Edwards returns.
This could be a difficult assignment right here for Stanford with Lee out of the ball game. But knowing you're going to have to play against Kentucky's pressure all game, you've got to give him some rest.
We've got a second ball handler in the game, Mike McConnell, number 4. Lee is on the bench. Weems got the numbers now. Freshman Collins kicks it out to Weems. Can't get a better look than that. Quick outlet pass from Shepard to Edwards.
Jimmy faded away on that shot when he was looking straight ahead instead of going towards the basket. Boy, McGlure is really setting a great target down inside. They ought to give him the ball.
Collins reached around, tipped it away. Turner penetrates, back out. Here's an open man, Shepard. Quick passing sets up Padgett. That would have given Kentucky the lead.
Jim, you always, of course, want to hit a teammate that's open better than you are. There's some action inside. McGlure trying to hold up Collins. But I think that Kentucky might have made one pass too many on that last possession. Shepard was in position to put it up.
I really thought he would take that.
Yeah.
It's his shot right at the top. They'll bring in a freshman now, Michael Bradley. He's seeing more action in every game from Worcester, Mass. Led his team to the state championship, Burncoat High School, scoring 41 last year. And Arthur Lee.
And both of these coaches going deep in the bench early in this basketball game. We're not even at the 10-minute mark. I guess we've had, what, about seven, eight guys play on each side.
Jaron Collins, it's the front end of a 1-1, freshman from North Hollywood, California. His twin brother is redshirting this year. Jason, expected to be a star also at Stanford. The most visible recruits in Stanford history.
Collins got it 23 minutes against Purdue, a very tough rebounding basketball team. It was 5 for 9, 12 points, 11 rebounds. So he's had a very good game in the NCAA tournament so far.
Out Edwards, or Turner with a no-look pass. And
that'll be a turnover Turner, but it was really a turnover Shepard. When you get that screen and roll, you've got to move Turner through it where Shepard should have been. What did Lee get, Jim? About a minute and a half, 2 minutes?
Not even.
Yeah, you can see Mike Montgomery just trying to give him rested, knowing that it's going to be a long game here with all of this pressure.
push off on Bradley.
Boy, Kentucky really getting into some foul trouble here. They've got a lot of fouls to waste with guys like Bradley, but you don't want to put this good free throw shooting team on the line.
This will put Pete Van Elswick, the only senior who really plays for Stanford, and he transferred from South Carolina, where he started 55 games in his career for the Gamecocks. 1-1 for Van Elswick. Been a part-time starter here. And Matson was out. He'll shoot one more.
What we're having, Jim, by Kentucky is not moving your feet. Now, they got to this tournament by playing great team defense. I mean, they're holding opponents to 35%. Today, when you see a lot of these cheap push fouls, that means guys aren't moving their feet, picking up fouls that are just poor defensive fouls. And maybe trying to push Stanford's not a good idea with all that bulk they have down low.
Interesting Kentucky lineup. And Shepard will shoot two. This is a Kentucky lineup without Evans, Muhammad, or McGlure on the court. They're about to change that as Evans is checking in.
Now, one of the things about having a deep bench is being able to utilize the guys in practice where they play in different combinations. So Tubby Smith is probably pretty comfortable, as was Rick Pitino, in taking his team to a national championship a few years ago with an even deeper quality team than this one, to have guys play in practice in different units.
Jeff Shepard had 18 points and 11 rebounds. Double-double against Duke.
Jim, you know the other thing you got to remember about Shepard against Duke? Who guarded Avery for the last 4 seconds? Yep. He forced him to change his dribble. The place that he wanted to go with the ball made him put it behind his back. So, very valuable defensive play.
And Duke didn't get a good shot off at all. A drive by Weah, blocked by Evans, and picked up by Edwards.
Tremendous play by Evans.
Shepard, untouched. They just let him run right through the lane.
And that brings Mike Montgomery off the bench. He will not allow a guy to have a drive all the way to the basket without somebody trying to draw the charge. As I said before, Evans comes off that bench and explodes for this team.
Van Elswick, partially blocked. Stanford's gone 5 minutes now without making a shot from the floor. Evans, good hands, but then took away. Had to make a tough catch, but then it was stripped.
Yeah, that was Van Elswick coming over, doing a nice job there. And another foul, this one on Shepard. And Lee looks like he's hurt a little bit. We'll see that drive by Shepard. Nobody getting over there to draw the charge. And that's something that Mike Montgomery is not going to go for. There you can see that knee against the upper thigh, and Lee goes down hard. Shepard, as you can see right there, young man from Atlanta, Mr. Basketball in Georgia, a 7-foot high jumper, so he flushed that last drive to the basket.
So Lee walks it off, and we'll see if this
31 straight free throw streak continues.
Let's see. This is where you can really see the streak in, getting up off an injury.
Usually when broadcasters talk about streaks, that's what it is.
That's the other thing. 1-1. Down.
That's good.
Averaging 19 in the tournament, 14 on the season, just a junior from Los Angeles.
He was 10 for 10 against Western Michigan from the line.
McGlure in for Kentucky.
McGlure, as much as anybody, turned this thing around with his good play on both ends of the floor when he came in for Najee Muhammad the first time.
Next foul on Kentucky will be double bonus time for Stanford the rest of the half. Stanford's last 5 points have come from the free throw line. Edwards challenging Sauer, who blocks it. And three Stanford players there for the rebound.
Very good defense by Sauer, because that was a good offensive maneuver. Smart play by Lee. Took it inside, nothing there, brings it back out.
Williams gets free on a pick. Three to the corner.
Boy, I like that kid. Showing a lot of moxie out here. Having a terrible tournament coming in. And he has put up positive shots every time he's had to.
Chris Williams with six. And the lead's back to six.
He was the MVP of the Cable Car Classic this year. There's no reason for him not to be playing well.
Van Elswick leaning in on McGlure. Too much.
Jim, one of the things that we could point out last year, the player of the year, Tim Duncan, in the NCAA tournament, went against his Stanford team. Mike Montgomery employed, remember, almost 20 fouls to use in the center position. Ben Elswick was one of those guys that leaned on Duncan.
He used Mark Seaton, he used Mark Mattson, Tim Young, and Ben Elswick. And the player of the year, so his career ends, surprisingly, in the second round of this Stanford team.
Galore doing everything right today.
Saul Smith, Scott Padgett back in for Kentucky. Turner and Edwards out, and Tim Young, starter for Stanford. The first seven-footer since Rich Kelly at Stanford returned. Two for two, McGlure.
Jimmy mentioned Rich Kelly. He holds the rebound record for Stanford. It's 27. He did it in 1974. No, he did it against the University of Kentucky. Only time these two teams have played before this.
He had a nice career in the NBA, too.
Absolutely.
Rich Kelly still lives out there in the Stanford Palo Alto area. Woodside guy. Here's Ween set three again.
That's a little bit tougher shot. Had to work against his body there. Didn't get his feet squared up.
Bounce pass to Padgett.
McGlure looking to set a screen on Shepard. Good help by Weems.
Shepard got a line drive. Lee, good defense on him.
He sure did, Jim. You're exactly right. It went right up in his face, took away the jump shot angle.
Stanford shooting better from three inside of the arc.
Well, that's been Lee and Weems out there.
Shooting, and on the back, Padgett, and Mattson got tangled. They called on Mattson.
What happened to Weems that time, Jim, is he went with the pump fake, thought he could get Shepard in the air, but Shepard stayed right with him. So we saw two good defensive plays on jump shooters. That one by Shepard, right before that by Lee.
Second on Mad Dog Mattson. Weems has taken half the attempts for the Cardinals so far. He's 2 of 9. From the field.
Well, that was one of our points coming in here. Would he show up or not? I think this probably he hasn't been that effective statistically, but if you're Mike Montgomery, you like to see a guy who thinks he can make those kind of shots. Now he has to have a little bit of selection.
There's Mike Montgomery, 12th year at Stanford after 8 seasons as the head coach at Montana. One more for Padgett.
Montgomery never had a losing season at Montana.
Scott Padgett, very consistent in this tournament.
Well, he's averaging almost 3.5 points more per game in the tournament than he did on the regular season.
It's a 2-point lead for Stanford. The Cardinal has led the whole way. Stanford scored the game's first 8 points. In fact, Arthur Lee scored the game's first 8. They've made 4 of 8 as the Cardinal from 3-point land, and Kentucky has misfired on its 4 attempts.
Jim, that's very unusual because Kentucky, a very good 3-point shooting team this year, shooting 37%. In the tournament, they've been shooting 43% from 3. And pretty good distribution as to the guys that were making those threes. So for them to be 0 for 4, really not what they've been doing and indicative of what they've been doing in the NCAA tournament.
You're talking about Mike Montgomery at Montana, never had a losing season. He coached Larry Krzyzkowiak, some may remember. He took that team NCAA 1 year.
Change in defense, a little half-court zone trap by Kentucky. First time we've seen it employed today, and then he dropped back in their zone. Lee recognizes what's going on. They post up 2 men down low inside it.
Ween shoots again from the corner of 3. His 3rd of the game.
Boy, give this kid a lot of credit. Very positive attitude.
Out of Kansas City, Kansas.
Mr. Basketball in Kansas.
Evans trying to match it.
Line driver there. Didn't get the good arch. You notice in the half-court set, Turner, who's not going to take the outside 3 very often, not as comfortable driving as he is when they can get it into a run-shoot full-court game as they did against Duke.
Smith, good bit of dribbling there. McGlure with the put back. That's the first time Stanford's been beat on the offensive glass.
Well, what happened here? Lee got set up with McGlure down on the inside. and had no chance. And here Tubby Smith using some strategy. Let's see what this zone can do. A 1-2-2 kind of matching up on the back line. Sauer will try three. McGlure, good pitch out to Turner. This is where he's so tough.
Cut off his penetration, so he takes the jumper.
That's his game, Jim. When he can play 60, 70 feet, put that ball on the floor, he is really tough inside 15 feet.
Eight different players have scored for Kentucky. Lead with three.
Great
only perfect.
Through.
17 for Arthur Lee.
Evans was shocked with Lee's range there. A terrific follow-through over a taller player.
Stanford now with six threes, none for Kentucky. Evans.
Oh, that was some good defense by Sauer.
How about the save by Padgett? And he gets it back. Can they hit a three? Not again.
And notice how Mike Montgomery doesn't want his team to get in a run-shoot ragtag game with this club. Good drive.
Oh, hands right on Lee. Everybody's fine.
Madsen with those 19 size sneakers.
Yeah.
Put a welt on Lee's back, I can assure you.
Quadruple E.
Or maybe it was a good rundown for him, you know?
Lee gets an assist and a kick in the pants. 31-25 Stanford. Padgett, hook shot over Madsen.
Now we've seen McGlure go left, and we've seen Padgett go right with basically the same move that coaches work on time after time in practice.
Montgomery signals to Lee, slow it down.
Exactly. He does not want this to be a game played all over the court. He wants to play half court at a time.
Double team. Madsen whips it back out to Lee. Flips the defenders and travel.
Just exactly what Mike Montgomery did not want.
Timeout on the floor. 31-27, the Cardinal.
Mentioned about the history of Stanford in 42, winning the national championship, beating Dartmouth 53-38. That was also Kentucky's first trip to the NCAA tournament. Not their first championship, but when you figure the three of the four teams here, Stanford won in 42, Utah won in 44, Kentucky won in 48, so they were the teams of the decades of the 40s, huh?
Well, you've got the teams of the 90s as the favorites here, Kentucky and North Carolina.
Well, Kentucky never let up. They stayed right with it.
Well, Utah and Stanford haven't won a championship since the 40s, while Kentucky and Carolina have won championships in the 90s. Padgett bypassed the three. Shepard takes it. First of the game for the Wildcats.
And Weems really upset with himself. Got stuck down in a pack.
It's the fourth time Kentucky has cut the lead to one. Kentucky has never led or pulled even.
Weems has done such a fine job fighting out to the pack. That time he got lost. Shepard burned him.
Got Arthur Lee on the bench.
Tubby got out of the zone.
Blocked by McGlure. Picked up by Young. Turn around with the right hand for the lefty.
Well, McGlure showed him a left-handed shot. Young shows him a right-handed shot. McDonald not making real good judgments, as did Lee. They've got to stop trying to take that ball down inside so far.
Turner short. And here's McDonald, freshman, whose father was a number one draft choice by the Boston Celtics in the 70s. Glenn McDonald out of Long Beach State. Collins misses the turnaround.
A little bit too quick a shot. With 2:22 to go, Stanford ought to occupy the ball a little more. Good cut.
Good pass by Padgett. And Shepard again brings Kentucky within one.
Yeah, the year that Jeff Shepard sat out, I'm sure that he was able to observe a lot of things that he could do without having the ball in his hands. Moving without the ball is an art. Shepard's showing you how to do it there.
He sat out all of last year to Shepard. Young calling for it. Got the position on McGlure.
Good power move by Young. He sealed McGlure. Now Young gives McGlure a little shot to the face. Coming down the court, Young's known to throw that high elbow. Be a cheap foul and one he doesn't want to give right now.
kick out. Three, Shepard. Would have tied it. Mendez with the rebound. Here's McDonald. Swings. Quick shot, quick trip by Stanford.
Not in the best interest of Stanford basketball. How about that move?
And Shepard touched it last. Stanford ball.
Very smart move by Edwards. Threw it all the way towards his basket rather than throwing it back in on his own to Stanford.
CBS Sportsline stat of the game. That continues to be quite a disparity in three-point success. Stanford 50%. Kentucky only one to drop so far. That by Shepard.
Probably the two key three-point shooters, Mills and Padgett, on that bench right now.
Just a minute to go in the half.
Showing the versatility. Evans down inside on a 6'10" Collins that holds him off.
Kick out to Mendez. And Evans with the rebound.
Good block out by Evans. Even though he's given up size, he knows how to use his young man transferred from Manhattan. Doing a good job in there now, playing basically power forward. They've got to give up the ball. Nice step out.
Turner. Edwards steps in. And a push off. Going against...
That's Evans.
Evans. It'll be a two-shot situation at the other end. Coming up on Pennzoil at the half, Greg Gumbel, Clark Kellogg, and Coach Dean Smith will have the analysis of the first half of this one. Coming up on Pennzoil at the half.
You know, Jim, one of the things that amazes me about Young is the number of minutes that he's played in this tournament. He played 33 against the College of Charleston, 39 against Western Michigan, 32 against Rhode Island. So he's a big man with some good stamina out there as long as he can stay out of foul trouble.
Has only one foul in this one. Jaren Collins to shoot two.
Nice release.
Stanford. Sunday, May the 3rd. You can experience the saga that begins where the last Don left off. The most anticipated television event of 1998. The Last Don 2, Mario Puzo's event coming May 3rd on CBS. So a 20-second timeout. Montgomery just a little refresher course for his team as they'll head back for the last 24 seconds to defend. One more free throw coming by Collins.
We have seen Kentucky in these situations love to set that screen with Shepard rolling out for the three at the top of the key. Let's see if they go to that set with just 24 seconds to go when he gets his ball.
Stanford 9 of 10 from the line. Back in front by 5.
They've got an advantage from the line and an advantage from 3. Hold it for the last shot. Does Kentucky a 1-4 set. Here comes the play for Shepard. Turner coming out.
Turner.
There he is.
Shepard, 3. Bounces away. Touch last by Stanford. 1.3 seconds on the clock.
And Tubby's going to use a timeout right here to set something up. Almost a tap play in order. Not enough time for anything else.
You know, in this first half, Stanford, Billy, has turned the ball over twice. Now, that's all.
Jim, a couple of reasons for that. First of all, Lee has done a fine job. And secondly, Kentucky's not getting a consistent flow of making baskets. When you don't do that, you don't have a tendency to be able to set up your press. Another thing, they have not been to the foul line. And so, therefore, you also can't have that press set up. So, good job by Stanford. Kentucky's got to shoot better.
Not that Kentucky's 4 turnovers is anything to be ashamed of either. So, 1.3, they'll inbound underneath. Little Kentucky.
You see where Shepard is set up underneath. Remember, an excellent leaper.
Evans looking inside, goes outside. Shepard gets the jumper. And it rattles out in the first half that was tightly contested but led by Stanford all the way. They led by as many as 10. Kentucky on five occasions pulled within one, but never pulled even. Let's go over to Armin Katayan. Armin?
Coach, it really looks like you're getting your game inside, scoring, rebound, defense.
Well, we're not getting as many things as we'd like inside. We shot the ball a little bit, and that's been pretty key for us. We haven't let them get in transition too much, and that's been great because they've been pretty good when they've gotten into transition. But we can do a better job defensively, particularly on Shepherd curling on us.
You got a big first half out of Lee, and he shut down Turner so far.
Well, yeah, he's done a good job, and we got to continue to do that. But, you know, we got to play a whole lot better in the second half.
Thanks, Coach. Jim, back to you.
Thank you, Armin. Stanford 37, Kentucky 32. And CBS Sports exclusive coverage of the NCAA Men's Basketball Championship will continue after this message and a word from your local station.
Movement right there. So you look at it, Stanford should be ahead when you look at the points.
Tubby Smith played Nazi Muhammad only 4 minutes in that first half as Muhammad picked up two quick fouls. The shooting percentages in the first half were identical. The 6 threes made by Stanford, 3 by Weems, 3 by Lee.
Jim, you never know when that shot is going to get away from you. That's why teams that win with solid defense, because the shot can sometimes come and go. For Kentucky to be shooting under 40%, they came in here in the tournament shooting 53.6. So they've got to figure that they're going to break out of it here sooner or later.
Throws it away to start the second half. Just the third turnover of the game.
Now, how about that way to start a game, Jim? In 3 seconds, you have a turnover and a foul. And lose possession of the ball. Very bad pass. Nobody came to meet it.
And the second on Young.
Let's see if Turner starts putting the ball on the floor and trying to penetrate a little bit more. He's got to get some action started. Nazi Muhammad pushing Young inside.
Edwards gets the roll. That's a two. He had a foot on the line. Gives him a chance to set up the press.
Good job going over the top. Good hit.
2-on-1. Weems to Young. Finds a slashing Madsen. Too strong on the lay-in.
And what he did, Jimmy, left the ground too soon and found himself in between shots.
Muhammad back
three
again. And Young has his third foul. Two quick ones. Two in the first 37 seconds of the second half. Three overall.
And that goes to show you how that cheap foul, and he has a tendency to pick those up. Any guy that gets in foul trouble makes a lot of cheap fouls. And Young is one of those guys that does that.
Madsen's fifth rebound.
On that last miss by Madsen, you either want to take the shot from 10 feet or dunk it on a play like that. He got caught in between.
Talked about Madsen and Padgett, a stalemate to this point. What do you expect in the second half in that matchup? Young backed in on Muhammad, took him to the floor, no call.
Well, that could have been a big call had it gone against Stanford. That would have been Young's fourth. I'm kind of surprised that Mike Montgomery with the lead doesn't take Young out of the ball game right now.
Muhammad tries to hook. Sauer, he's been good inside today, rebounding.
Sauer and Madsen as secondary rebounders really have done a fine job.
Here's Madsen working on Padgett.
He likes it in there, and he overpowered Padgett that time.
41-34, Stanford.
You got to give Madsen the credit when he goes down inside the paint against Padgett. Padgett the credit when he steps outside against Madsen.
Landed on him. So Shepherd to the line for two.
Boy, Shepherd really coming off those curl moves beautifully. Mike Montgomery mentioned that on his way out during halftime. They're going to have to do a better job helping Weems when Shepherd comes off the curl. Somebody's got to step out there and block the pass. Weems hurt himself a little bit as well.
Yeah, he's trying to cover it up. Doesn't want the coach to see it. He wants to stay in the game. Stretch it out, tie the shoe a little bit, but he's still in pain. Shepherd had 27 starts at point guard back in 1995. You think about some of the other players that crossed his era at Kentucky, the likes of Tony Delk and Anthony Epps.
Epps, by the way, now is at Georgetown College, NAIA school, going to play football. He was obviously a great high school footballer. How about the finish?
Young tips it up twice, second time by
Madsen. Madsen starting to come alive.
Turner penetrates. Oh, and Young pulls down the board.
Now here's exactly what Mike Montgomery does not want. He does not want Stanford to get in a run-and-shoot type thing. Even when they make them, it sets the stage for Kentucky basketball, not Stanford basketball.
Sauer's three gives Stanford the 10-point lead, matching the largest of the game. Muhammad gets two back.
I think it'd really be smart for Mike Montgomery to take Young out of this ball game now. He's got three fouls on him. He's playing well. They've got a nice lead. They can afford to go a couple of minutes with him on the bench.
Talking with Coach Montgomery yesterday, we desire a tempo and a pace we're comfortable with.
Ooh,
this
push
might
off.
Be a little faster than they want. It's going the other way.
Yeah.
One against Stanford, one against Madsen. His third. Three on Young, three on Madsen.
Now Mike Montgomery really has a problem. And Jim, remember what I said before, the shot, even though Sauer made it, we saw Stanford falling into the trap of playing a run-and-shoot type game, which is what Kentucky wants to do. Now, you may hit a shot, but that's not what you want to do. Half court at a time is Stanford's advantage. Kentucky certainly has a big advantage when they're going to run and shoot.
Drop it inside. Muhammad again. Back-to-back trips.
Great post-up job by Nazi Muhammad.
Over the top. Seaton in for the first game. Mark Seaton. Lee and Jay again. They shoot quickly and they hit the three. Arthur Lee with 16 leading the way for Stanford.
The MVP of the West Regional showing why, isn't he?
From the start, too. Muhammad, what a move. Nifty move and three straight trips. Nazi Muhammad has scored.
And Nazi with those two fouls in the first half really took away a major weapon for Kentucky.
Yeah.
He had to sit on that bench for a long time.
McGlure will come in for Muhammad. Great sequence for Nazi. The big Z on that. Well, that last 3 minutes, last three possessions. This is where they turned it over to start the second half. The inbound at this time, the Weems.
There's the cool move. Weems gets caught inside. Nice double team by Kentucky.
And a traveling violation on Stanford.
Weems had to realize he wasn't open on the curl, make the dish right away.
Go to the break. 49-42, Stanford by 7. These aerial pictures provided by Goodyear. The Alamo City of San Antonio, what a festive place it has been for all these college basketball fans to celebrate this great tournament. Coach Mike Krzyzewski and wife Mickey watching the action. And there's Tommy and Stephanie, Dr. Stephanie Amaker, the Seton Hall coach, Tommy Amaker.
Former Duke assistant and great player and went to the Final Four a time or two himself.
Young on the bench for Stanford with three fouls.
Solid screen set out on the outside. Stanford stayed in his tight man-to-man the entire ball game. Kentucky showed a little zone in the first half.
Edwards with a three. Only the second of the game for Kentucky.
The difference in this basketball game has been perimeter shooting, something Kentucky has done so well to get to the Final Four. They've been cold up to that shot in this game.
Lee breaks the press.
Nice job by Seaton to come out and create a passing lane.
15 on the shot clock. Stanford is led by 10 in both halves. Never trailed. And a whistle against Edwards.
Yeah, Edwards hurt his knee a little bit and bumped into his own teammate right there. And that was not a good foul by Kentucky. They were playing. They had a good defensive standoff. Now they get back to 35 seconds to score again. Smart play by Lee. Pull it out, reset, get Mattson involved in a half-court set here.
The pass, Shepard took it away. Shepard with Sauer chasing.
Why did he foul like that? Shepard's got to put away. You know Shepard's a great dunker. Let him go. And you can see right there, Sauer realizes he did not make a smart play. Lucky he didn't get called for the intentional. There's the pass. Shepard using his quickness to beat Sauer to the spot. Makes a steal now. Watch right here. Sauer, who's played good defense today, no reason to make that play. Could have been called intentional, Jim.
Nazi Muhammad was calling for it, but he'll shoot just one.
You know Shepard is a great dunker, so you have no chance whatsoever to stop him on an open break like that. Just let him go and finish it off.
He pulls Kentucky to within one. For the sixth time in this game, a basket, and our Paul Sherwood tried to draw the charge. Knows that camera took a pretty good hit down there. Sauer will sit, and he's still smarting after that foul.
And he knows he made a mistake, and you know, as Kentucky is scoring more consistently, Jim, it enables them to get the feel of their full court defensive pressure.
Mosley drives wide. Just knocked the tempo Stanford wants.
And I'm going to go back to that jump shot that Sauer made and establish a tempo that is really not in Stanford's best interest. Kentucky taking advantage of it.
Yeah, you think it's great at first. You hit the three, but you're suddenly seduced into a tempo and a pace that you're not comfortable with.
I'll go back to the Duke game, which Kentucky showed great confidence as a team and pulled together so beautifully. Remember when Wojcicki hit the jumper? It really wasn't what Duke needed at that time. They needed to go inside and make Cubby Smith come back with a bigger lineup. Cubby was so patient that day. Terrific coaching job. Was able to keep the smaller, quicker team on the floor.
Sophomore from Las Cruces, New Mexico. West of here on Interstate 10. David Mosley hits two free throws to up the lead to three. Padgett's back in for Kentucky. And Shepard sits.
Mosley's had a pretty good scoring tournament so far. He's on Evans right now, so he's got a tough defensive assignment. And there goes Evans with a curl.
Floor working on Seaton. Probably not the shot they wanted.
Boy, Kentucky setting some good screens. Nice pick and roll action.
Tough pass. Padgett trying to bounce it inside, but the Wildcats keep it.
Jim, don't you get a feeling right now, a little momentum swing for Kentucky, the way that the frenetic pace, the way the game's being played?
Well, the thing is, six times they pulled within one, never pulled even. You just think one of these times they're going to break through and maybe put together a magnificent run.
Well, Montgomery sitting over there trying to be patient with Young on the bench. That takes away a big offensive weapon. But he has three fouls on him.
Evans, three, and into the arms of Mattson.
So far, both Lee and Turner have done a fine job against each other, not turning the ball over.
Lee driving to the line for two.
Wow,
almost automatic. Entangled bodies inside. Padgett and Seaton.
Well, McGlure was going to make sure that Seaton didn't finish anything off in case that whistle hadn't been blown. Here we see Lee going down inside, gets fouled by any number of players, and look at McGlure. No, you're not going to get that shot off. Good, solid, hard-nosed basketball right there. Nothing that warranted any special kind of foul. Foul had already been called.
Nazi Muhammad goes to the scorer's table, and they'll sit him down first. Come in a moment.
Bobby Smith, very vocal over on the sidelines. Young man went to High Point College.
North Carolina.
You know, Tubby has set a lot of traditional breakthroughs. He was only one of three black students at High Point College at the time. Just think of all the breakthroughs he's had. Obviously, the first black coach in the history of Kentucky basketball, and handles himself with such great confidence and ability.
So Arthur Lee's father. High Point College produced quite a pro player. Some may remember from the ABA days, Gene Littles.
Tubby still going to it over there. Tubby played for a former teammate of mine, Jerry Steele. Probably got some of that spirit from Jerry.
Three teams,
backed
Tubby's
up to no one.
Yep. Three teams he's taken to the NCAA tournament in the 90s. Three times to the Sweet 16.
Jim, we never could research it, but I don't think anybody has ever taken three different teams in 5 years to the Sweet 16.
He did that with Tulsa.
I couldn't find any.
No, Tulsa, Georgia, and Kentucky.
And there are those free throws again by Stanford. Every time Kentucky gets ready to move, Stanford gets on that line.
Turner, whistle,
wow.
And one.
He is so good. 15 to 12 feet. He loves that floating shot.
The only thing he's missing from his game today, Billy, has been his terrific assist-to-turnover ratio in tournament play. So far today, he has not had an assist. He's turned it over twice.
Here you see him turn the corner, and this is what I talk about. 15 to 12 feet on in. That is where he is so comfortable. He's got those gliding, floating shots. Very active.
He has a chance here to bring it to two,
but not a good free throw shooter. The difference between he and Lee at that point guard position. Major difference.
Young will be coming in on the next whistle for Stanford. Mosley. In and out. Seaton gets it back. Smartly sends it back out, and Weems resets it also to Lee.
And a nice job by Weems instead of taking up. Quick jump shot like he did in the first half, getting a better shot. This is more Stanford basketball.
Oh, throw it away, and Muhammad. It's down to one for the seventh time in the game.
No reason whatsoever for Seton not to meet that pass. Good job by Nazi Muhammad, the young man who took his body fat from 24 down to 12. Shows you how it paid off with that quickness.
He's having some second half. Lee, ball gets loose. Seaton fights for it. And under the basket, no call. Kentucky can take the lead for the first time in the game.
How about Evans pulling it back out? Boy, Tubby has just kind of like willed this team to this point. Been on that sideline, very vocal. Driving this club.
Pass
nice
it
player.
Underneath. This is the tippy.
A perfect back screen setup lob for Padgett. He didn't finish.
They cannot break through. Gave it up late, and the pass almost went in.
Well, you can see right now that Stanford is flustered. Mike Montgomery, if Kentucky scores here and can't stop the clock, he needs to go ahead maybe and use one of his timeouts to get some of these players in, particularly Young.
Well, the next whistle, if we're under 12, right, would be an official timeout anyway. But Kentucky, again, can take the lead for the first time in San Antonio.
But no whistle on a score, Jim, and what Kentucky wants right now is to keep this game going.
Muhammad backing in. In and out. Evans tip. Boy, they've had two great chances. Two trips right underneath. Coming up empty. Mosley baseline. Tough pass. Forced it inside.
Yeah, nothing there whatsoever. Evans off on a
Turner. Turner. And Evans gets it back. On the line, but Kentucky ball.
And luckily, Mike Montgomery was calling timeout, and he realized that he'd get the TV timeout. He didn't have to use it.
The violation. Now watch something. Here's the hand. This ball must be in the basket or on the rim when that hand is in contact, or else it's not a violation. So watch what happens right here. The hand never touches the ball. The ball, before it's on the rim or in the basket, the hand is released from the rim. So consequently, the referees were all over that. Incredible that they could be that much on the money. It looks strange, but it wasn't a violation.
Kentucky has possession underneath its own goal, down one. Stanford's turnover total has just soared in the second half.
Shepard dishes to McGlure. A turnover this time.
What could you tell on that play, Jim? You got to remember that you're passing the ball to McGlure, not to Nazi Muhammad. And McGlure is not going to catch that kind of pass thrown in the downward arc. That's so tough. Nazi has better hands.
Tough pass. Padgett had a chance to intercept it. Somehow Young got it.
Boy, though, Kentucky is turning this into a helter-skelter game, which really favors them.
And another turnover. Williams knocks it out.
Very surprised that Turner went up in the air then and threw the ball. He likes to keep the ball in his hands in that case and take it to the goal.
Cameron Mills. He hit such a big shot against Duke, his first of the tournament. Former walk-on, wearing the number that was once donned by his father, Terry, when he played for Adolph Rupp back in the late 60s, early 70s.
Jim, I think it's really important when Stanford gets the ball the next time to make sure that Young touches it.
Turner, back out to Mills.
Good decision.
Left-handed shot and a push. Padgett to the line. Near the conclusion of the game, we will select the genuine Chevrolet most valuable player from each team. To date, Chevrolet has contributed over $6.5 million to the scholarship funds of America's colleges and universities. And now Padgett in full even, full Kentucky even with Stanford. This was their fourth trip. Chance to take the lead.
Jim, isn't it interesting when teams have a certain design? We talked about the top of the game. Kentucky wants to play 94 feet. And you had the case of Stanford would like to play half court at a time. So far in the second half, Kentucky has been forcing Stanford to play their game. It really has paid off for them. Well, I think, how do you turn this around if you're Stanford? The answer is, you've got to take your time bringing it up, and Lee has got to get the ball into Young to turn it back into a half-court game.
There it is, first lead of the day for Kentucky. With 10 minutes to go in this first semifinal.
Weems does not want to put that ball on the floor, as does Lee.
Bauer. Oh, and look at the shot clock, Billy.
Right.
1 second to go for him to get that across.
All Evans had to do was to move his feet, which is Tubby is saying right now. Move the feet, don't reach in with the hands, and you had the turnover.
Second whistle on Evans. A new 35 for Stanford.
Now let's see if they try to get the ball to Young. Boy, Evans out here. He makes it tough to throw over him.
Williams baseliner. Young blocked by Muhammad. And Kentucky picks it up. Cameron Mills. Huge play by Nazi Muhammad.
Kentucky really putting the pressure on, forcing that ball up the court quickly.
Muhammad calling for it.
You notice no double down.
Oh, what a half. Muhammad wants it. And they're all dropping for him in the second half.
Well, Jim, I think you got Young with three fouls. The ball goes into Nazi Muhammad. You got to drop somebody down to double him. You can't let him play him one-on-one in there. And here's the move for Stanford. Get the ball into your big guy.
They double team him, but Young makes the power move.
That's the answer for Stanford. Then he can kick back out and get Weems shooting his three again.
Kentucky controlling inside, but this time the freshman Collins with the theft.
What happened to Turner that time, Jim? He was looking and concentrating so much on the cutter that he never saw Collins standing there. Double down by Kentucky.
Weems puts it on the floor and it fires.
Oh, he hurt his ankle. He twisted his ankle on the way down.
Turner penetrates, back out. Muhammad blocked this time by Young. And Weems is still struggling.
The best thing that happened to Weems is that he had to run the ankle sprain off and probably going to allow him to stay in a basketball game.
He signaled to the bench. He waved them off. He wants to stay in. Keep moving.
What's happening right now? Padgett and Nazi Muhammad are doubling on Young. They're not playing Collins. Collins should be open for a rebound.
Under 10 on the shot clock. They grabbed his jersey. Weems puts it up wildly. Gets it back. Bad ankle. And Weems gives him the lead back.
Jim, Weems was forced to go on the defensive end and run off the ankle sprain, and that's what's kept him in the game. Normally you say, gee, we're going to be 5-4. We're in trouble.
Muhammad to the line. 4-2. The fourth on Young.
Here we have
the jersey here, huh?
No, this is an intentional foul. Poorly, in the fact that it was not called by the official, it's hard to believe that they did not see that. Should have been an intentional foul. Would have put Weems on the line for two and the ball back. Weems been very well officiated, but they sure missed that one.
Four on Tim Young.
Hey, he's still in the game, Jim. And I can't believe this. There's a lot of time left.
Well, they're bringing Madsen in for him now.
Yeah, but you don't want to take any chance if the shots get up there. You can't get them in the game.
Four subs in for Kentucky. Madsen in for Stanford. And there goes Young.
And remember, Jim, the foul. The foul at the start of the second half that Young picked up, the very cheap foul. Instead of being now just with three tough interior fouls, he picks up the cheap one. That gives him four. He's got a sit.
Sits with 7:23 to go in the game.
Young man, all SEC first team right here. Now,
and the two free throws gives Kentucky the one-point advantage. Timeout on the floor. Kentucky leads by one. Courtside, this magnificent edition of March Madness only continues with our first semifinal, just a one-point game. Second half points off turnovers. Look at that category, Billy.
Changed an awful lot right there in regard to Kentucky's big advantage. And Jim, that's overcoming the fact that they have not been able to get untracked at all from the perimeter. McGlure and Muhammad have been excellent. So has Tim Young. But right now, you'd have to say big advantage, Kentucky. Young on the bench with four. Nazi Muhammad and McGlure in good shape.
Good pressure applied by Kentucky. Up. And you start to wonder, too. You have to endure this the whole game if you're Arthur Lee. When do you start wearing down, making mistakes like that with fatigue being part of the factor?
I think he's been fairly well rested, but there was a case where all he needed to do was to keep his dribble alive for two more dribbles and then make a realistic pass. You have to wonder if Sauer's knee problem didn't hurt him a little bit having to turn on that particular pass, Jim.
Jaron Collins riding the back of Padgett. Game two, the Utah Utes. West champions against the East champion North Carolina Tar Heels. That's coming up after this one.
Well, Jim, we talked about the fact at the start of the show that, in my opinion, all four of these teams win their next game. And I think that Stanford has proved that they belong on the floor with Kentucky, at least at this point they have. And I think Utah will do likewise with North Carolina. Scott Padgett, another solid, solid day.
But what's really been impressive is the play at the other end, as Madsen has only four for Stanford. They've been matched up head-to-head all afternoon.
They really have. Padgett coming off of the All-South Regional team. You can see that Stanford employing a lot of the same principles that Utah used against Arizona against the press. Throwing over the top, letting their big men catch. There's Shepard on a hold on Weems, not wanting him to get the curl move started.
But only the fifth team foul against Kentucky, so they'll inbound underneath. Both of these teams with dramatic comeback wins last Sunday. Hashimu Evans for Shepard.
Boy, that's a nice substitution pattern right there. Two guys that you know are going to produce for you. Shepard sits down. Looks like he's very confident with that smile on his face. Nice move.
Over the top, Collins. McGlure on the body and a push-off call. They don't count the basket.
That's a tough break for Stanford there because Collins withstood the banging and then doesn't even get to go to the foul line. You'll see, without question, McGlure will push him right here. Collins regains his steps, finishes off, but it doesn't count.
And Muhammad for McGlure. What a tandem they've been today.
They've been terrific. And I think with Moore's play, Jim, when he knew he had to go in and play solid minutes in the first half with Najee Muhammad and the two fouls, really the key to Kentucky staying close. Sauer really limited on that leg. Seems like he's running about 60%. Jim, you said he likes to stand and shoot as opposed to putting the ball on the floor, but that time he showed us a little something.
Did he ever?
Weems this year, highest since Todd Lichty had 34 points against Oregon. Lichty had 35 in 1989. Anybody that can hit 34 in a ball game certainly should be able to come up with more than just a standstill jumper, and Weems showed it to us right there.
And he knows how to get the call. His father was a former official in the Big 8 Conference. Misses on the chance to tie, but even better yet for Stanford, they get control of it and can regain the lead.
Oh, a bad switch by Najee Muhammad.
And Lee puts Stanford in front at 61-60.
The big man didn't want to take Lee, but he should have stayed with him. Gave him a wide open jumper.
6 minutes to go, over the top to Muhammad. He beat Manson, who was trying to front him. They just went right over the top.
Look at the press now that Kentucky's putting on. They're double-teaming the ball handler every time in the backcourt. They got to watch 10 seconds again.
Beat it by a second. Weems for a three.
Why? Why taking quick shots? Ozzie's got the lob opportunity again.
Saved by Smith to Edwards. Drives, gets the layup.
He froze the defense with his eyes that time. They thought he was going to be patient enough to pull it back out. He put it on the floor.
64-61, Kentucky.
It's a huge basket right here. A huge possession, rather. I think if you're Mike Montgomery, you got to think about coming back in with Young.
Tough shot. Weems gets it to go.
He had no place else to go with that, Jim. No passing lane. Had to make the shot.
Remember that one as we just moved under 5 minutes.
That's a young man that was 0 for 10 against Purdue in the win.
Najee Muhammad would like that ball. A post-up move inside. Seven on the shot clock.
There he is.
Turnaround. Muhammad rattles out. And Collins with two hands secures it.
What a nice job by Kentucky to get the ball to the man they wanted to touch it. Stanford coaches calling plays out on the side with flashcards.
And Weems to the line for two. Foul on Smith. His second.
You know, we talked about the high academic standards. You're supposed to be able to play the game and read the flashcards at the same time, Jim.
When it gets helter-skelter, that's off. No, yeah, a lot.
I'll tell you what, if I'm the coach, if I'm one of the players, I say to the coach, hey, coach, they're pressing me full court. I'm trying to dribble, and you're throwing flashcards at me. You know, please.
That ties it. Shepherd and Turner in the Kentucky lineup.
Well, I can't say enough about Weems today, Jim. You know, you get in a short running tournament like these 3 weeks are, you start going south, and it's really hard to pull yourself back together. This kid's showing a lot of courage here, coming right out in the beginning of the game and saying, you know what, I'm a good shooter, I'm going to show you, I'll put it up there.
Stanford's in front by one. Under 4 minutes to play. Calling for it. Backing in Collins.
Oh, he got the roll. And there it is. A more mature player going against a freshman and just kind of overpowering him with upper body.
Runs the baseline, does Mosley.
Lee better keep his dribble alive here. Keep his dribble alive. Big mistake.
And Padgett read it all the way.
Big mistake. You got to keep that dribble alive.
Padgett gives it up. Evans, too strong. And Lee runs it down in the corner.
When you're dribbling up against that double team, Jim, you're better off going backwards rather than picking up your dribble. You pick up the dribble, you play right into the defense's hands.
Mosley, he can shoot it. Not this time. Madsen with position
and a foul. Terrific position by Madsen inside on Nazi Muhammad. And he is so strong, is the madman. Mosley being a good shooter.
He's not the madman. He's the mad dog.
Mad dog, all right. But he had tremendous position right here. Mark Madsen putting it up. Nazi Muhammad can't stop him. He is such a strong kid. And really not a kid. He went on a mission for 2 years before he started playing his limit. And there's that little wiggle we saw in the Rhode Island game.
9 rebounds for Madsen. From Danville, California, one of 10 children. Madsen, 3-point play. The 8th lead change we've had in the second half. There's a timeout on the floor, an official timeout. Stanford has regained the game's lead. The family of head coach Mike Montgomery, his wife Sarah, son John, daughter Annie. Each team with two full, two 20s, and the arrow belongs to Kentucky.
Jim, you mentioned 1942 when Stanford won it at this very day. It'll cost Mike Montgomery more tonight to feed that family than what Stanford took home in a check. They made $93.79 was their take from the NCAA tournament in 42.
Oh! Stanford with a three-pointer and the 9th lead change of the second half.
Jeff Shepard doing a great job coming off of those curls today. Dangerous pass.
Touch pass by Turner.
Turner whistles and says to the referee, excellent call.
So right out of the break, the Shepard three gives Kentucky the 69-68 lead.
We'll see if Lee keeps his dribble alive this time. Boy, those are dangerous passes. Stanford fans wanted a foul there. Officials letting them play. It's pretty aggressive out there.
Both teams will be in a double bonus the rest of the way.
I think Stanford should still try to go down into Young a little bit.
10 seconds on the shot clock. Lee on. And Turner. Oh, Turner blocks it. And Cameron Mills comes out with it. Well, defensive play by Turner.
Lee tried to challenge him again. I think it really makes sense for Stanford to go inside to Young because that means the double team takes place, makes Madsen wide open on the put-up.
Under two to play. Madsen over Madsen.
Not a big shot. Good block out by Madsen on the shooter.
And the Mad Dog gets it back for Stanford.
You notice how he made Padgett go out of bounds to try to circle back in for the rebound. Good block out. Again, Young wanting that ball inside. Nobody wanted to throw it to him.
Lane short on the jumper.
They would get better shots by going inside and let it come back out.
1:20 remaining. Wildcats with the lead. And 20-second timeout. Padgett and Madsen were the... Well, the guys who hit the game-winning shots a week ago, Kentucky for, well, its win against Duke. Padgett from the top of the key. Madsen off the Lee steal for Stanford. It's a moment like that just waiting to happen here.
Well, you can see Dubby Smith using that timeout wisely here. 1:17 to go. He wants to get his guys fully appraised of what he expects them to do on this possession. And if you're Stanford down the other end, Jim, you've got plenty of time in this basketball game. But you got to go inside, and I'll tell you why. Turner can handle Lee one-on-one. Shepard is a fine one-on-one matchup with Weems.
Shepard, three-pointer. Again, two huge threes by Jeff Shepard.
Hey, Kentucky. Bobby Smith do it any better than that. He calls and sets up a perfect play with his 22nd timeout.
That gives them their biggest lead of the game, a four-point lead. Under a minute. They came back from six down with a minute to play against Rhode Island. Now they must somehow come back from four against Kentucky. Lee, it's put back by Madsen. And a timeout. Stanford got it.
Nice job by Madsen, not only to make the shot, but also to have the presence of mind to call the quick timeout. On the curl play set up specifically by Tubby Smith, Shepard, who has been on fire. Jim, just think about a young guy with that terrible ankle injury. There's Madsen on his putback. A lot of people probably thought he might never come back for the rest of the NCAA tournament. He came back after missing just one game and has played great basketball in this tournament. Against South Carolina State, he was only 1-for-4, but then against St. Louis, 18 points, 7-11. Against UCLA, 16 points. Against Duke, 5-for-11, 10 points, and 11 big rebounds.
All right, we have 48 seconds to go. Kentucky leads by two. What a big putback, though. Could have been Kentucky possession and a four-point lead. But Madsen came crashing down the lane. Owen, a reach in, will send Turner, not a good free throw shooter, to the line for two.
Jim, not only not a good free throw shooter, a very poor free throw shooter. When you take into consideration, and one of his only weaknesses as a player, only 64%, which is up from the 56% he shot in his career coming into this season.
But the thing you like about him in this situation, as Kentucky now is hand in hand, is he has been a postseason giant for Kentucky. Two shots.
No, I think you got plenty of time to take the two.
Madsen out high. Weems. Lee takes the three for the tie.
Oh.
26 seconds to go.
What
Kentucky
made,
needs help.
What made it? There's
and
a steal.
A near steal by Madsen.
Jim, what made that is Weems tried to go ahead and take his shot, but he couldn't get it off, and he had to throw it out. Lee was wide open. You see it right here. Some shot by the man that was the MVP of the West and continuing here at the Final Four.
And a timeout called by Stanford. Tie game, 24 seconds remaining. Kentucky ball.
The curl for Shepard has been very hot. The other thing is the back screen lob pass. Remember the one that Padgett did not was not able to make earlier in this half? I wouldn't be a bit surprised to see that play as well.
Turner in the game with Edwards, Padgett, Muhammad, and Shepard.
1-4 set. Hey, they're going to play for the last shot, it looks like. Take their chance to play them in overtime.
Muhammad tried to set a pick out high. 7 seconds to go. Turner drives. Turner comes up for Stanford. They look for the timeout. Weems fires it.
They tried to get the timeout. Jim, I really think they could have had much as 2 seconds and couldn't get the time.
0.7 seconds on the clock, and Turner had a highly desirable shot for Kentucky.
Well, give credit to both Turner and Lee. Turner got the shot that he wanted. Lee did a great job defensively, keeping his chest in front of him. And there's where Stanford just couldn't get the timeout quick enough.
Timeout on the floor. We'll be right back. The officials are reviewing, trying to ascertain if Stanford should have more time than 0.7 seconds.
And Jim, the officials right now are saying they haven't decided yet, so they're asking Tubby Smith and Mike Montgomery to keep their teams there. You know, we'll see the play right here. They're trying to get the timeout right there, Madsen, when there's almost like 1.8 seconds, but they didn't get the call. Now, the officials are working on it, looking at the television monitor over at the scorer's table. Let's see how much time they're going to put on there.
I think 1.1 seconds. Timmy Higgins just signaled to Tubby Smith.
Nice job by Tubby from a standpoint of accepting
the official decision here.
Stanford will have to inbound just outside of midcourt.
But I think it's going to be 1.1 seconds on the clock.
Yes, indeed. So that gives them a little more time to catch and shoot. And they brought in Ryan Mendez, a Texas scoring phenom out of Burleson, Texas, number 32.
Well, they've got Weems. They've got Mosley taking the ball out of bounds. You've got Weems, who's a pretty good curl shooter. You have Mendez, who's a pretty good curl shooter. And then Young is in the ball game for the long pass. And I think they're going to try to set a screen so the curl shooter can shoot at half court. And what Tubby's doing is saying, I want to see your alignment, and then I'll go out and play defense against you.
20-second timeout. Kentucky checked the look. Mosley was going to be the inbounder for Stanford. What kind of shot do you think they'll get to shoot here?
Well, Jim, what I think they're going to try to do is to use Young to set screens. I don't see from that alignment a situation where they'll try to throw it at the rim for Young or Mendez. So I think they're looking for a jump shot for Weems or Mendez coming off a curl move. Now, one of the things you'd like to do, where the ball is out of bounds, you'd love to have a left-handed jump shooter here. But they don't have either one on the floor that can do that. So it'll be a tough jump shot on a curl.
Tough pass with Muhammad guarding the inbounds pass. Mosley cannot move. Must get it in to Weems. Bounces once. Shoots. Short. Overtime in game one.
Well defended. Tough situation for Stanford with all right-hand shooters.
Overtime at the Final Four. We'll be right back.
Jim, one of the things you get an extra timeout in overtime, but one of the things you don't get, and I'm looking at that young man right there, he does not get an extra foul. So Young comes into this overtime with four on him, so Kentucky in better shape in a low post.
Madsen anticipating, perhaps.
He stole the tap, unlike the first tap of the game.
One overtime game on the season for Stanford. It was a loss against Arizona State, one of only four losses on the year.
Kentucky had won, and they beat Arkansas.
Weems, Edwards crashed in, so he drove in. Rattles out, maybe over the back.
And that's Young, and as I said, you don't get an extra foul in overtime, so Young's going to sit. And I go back to the foul that he committed right at the start of the second half. That was a cheap one. There's nothing he can do here. Big advantage, Kentucky. You see Nazi Muhammad blocking him out, keeping him off the boards.
That
Young
wasn't much of a foul there, Billy.
Very cheap foul.
Was it a cheap foul or no foul?
Well, maybe no foul. You know, when you consider at this point in the game, these referees have been allowing him to play. That was almost, and gained no advantage by that contact. A foul is when you make contact and gain an advantage. Young sure didn't on that play.
Muhammad to shoot two. Made three out of four at the line today. Quite an improvement. A year ago in the championship game, the overtime loss to Arizona, Muhammad was 0 for 6 from the line. Yep. How about that, Kentucky's in back-to-back overtime games at the Final Four, the championship game to Arizona and here today.
Yep.
Long and picked out, looked like by Edwards.
Yeah, I thought Edwards was the last one to touch it. Official looking for some help, and he got it. On the money there. Kentucky keeps up the full court relentless pressure. Now Lee has got to be questioned as to how much stamina he's at. He's been fighting his pressure for a good 20 minutes.
Mad Dog snapped it right over the hands of Mosley.
You want to get the ball back to Lee if you're Stanford. That relentless pressure from Kentucky eventually takes its toll.
Was an unforced error, really. No one on it. And Muhammad, left-hander, back of the rim. Still, Kentucky keeps it.
Well, Nazi lost control of the ball there with that left hand, but he had excellent position down inside. Madsen giving up about 3 inches with it. With his Collins on Padgett. Again, the curl by
of Young really hurt Stanford. Collins certainly not the low post threat. Maybe Mattson could pick up the slack here inside.
Mosley, three. Front of the rim. Kept alive, but into the arms of Padgett. Momentum with Kentucky in the overtime. 3.5 to go.
I think Padgett thinks that he can overpower Collins down in low.
Muhammad believes he can do the same on Mattson. Fade away, though, in the first five of the overtime to the Wildcats.
Stanford doesn't like to double down, but they're almost going to have to now because Mattson giving up so much size.
Timeout of 20, followed by Stanford.
Jim Young on that bench. Tough situation for Mike Montgomery.
Kentucky with 6 national championships, second only to UCLA. 13 Final Fours with this one in 98. Second only to North Carolina and UCLA, 14 apiece. People forget, when we talk about the 42 national champs, there are only 8 teams in the tournament then. FDR was the president. And by the way, there were 48 states.
Howie Delmar was the MOP of that particular tournament. And also on that club, the great Jim Pollard, Hall of Famer from Stanford. Mattson wants to clear out inside.
Over the top to Collins. Stuffed once. Gets it back and one. Oh, this freshman has great composure.
Yes, he does. And Jim gives Stanford a lot of credit there. What they anticipated was the fact that there was going to be a double by Padgett coming in to help on Mattson. So they threw right over the top of it. Padgett couldn't get back in time. And as you said, give Collins a lot of credit for the putback.
And this is the 4th foul on Muhammad.
Collins, as I said, had the big game with 23 minutes against Purdue. 5 for 9. 12 points, 11 rebounds.
That's his first miss of the game from the line after making his first 4. It would have cut it to 2, so a big miss. Halfway through the overtime. Kentucky by 3, 78-75. Edwards 3 on the baseline.
What happened there, Jim, is that Edwards, instead of coming out on the curl, ran the baseline. Mosley tried to go all the way over the top to chase him. You can see here he comes. He had run all the way across the top. And it gave Edwards an excellent opportunity to score on the baseline.
Alvin Edwards still going through the healing process. He lost his mother, Laura Mae Edwards, 4 weeks ago, dying of breast cancer. Lure in for Muhammad.
And you see what Tubby Smith is doing now, Jim. He's going to go offense, defense the rest of the way. McGlure comes in, hopefully, to play as much defense as possible. Nazi available on the offensive end.
Makes it a 4-point Kentucky lead.
And Turner really sits down defensively.
Lee with a 3. And tips it and gets it back. Huge shot here. Lee, 3. And he's hammered by Turner to the line for 3 attempts where he hasn't missed in the entire tournament.
Give Mattson some credit for determination going after that loose ball. Tubby Smith didn't like it. He thinks his team's quicker. They're supposed to beat people to the ball.
Lee 6 for 6 today from the line.
Mattson with a good kick out. Foul. Turner hits him with a leg.
And that dropped. He could have tied it. Could have been a 4-point play. Still Lee proves his remarkable free throw standard in the tournament to 33 of 33.
And Jimmy, remember when Arthur Lee used the choke sign in a non-sportsmanlike way when Patino Mobley was on that foul line?
Isaiah Muhammad back in with his four fouls.
He understood and took
a lot of heat for it.
Took a lot of heat.
And rightfully so.
Rightfully so, and handled himself in a professional manner. I don't think we'll see that out of him again.
He sent a letter of apology. Apologized here as well. And Lee hits all three to bring it back to one with 2 minutes to go. Lee has 26.
Padgett, again, posting up down low on Collins, but they're not looking to get him the ball.
Comes over out high. Padgett fakes the three. Now drive. Goes for the dunk. And it's Kentucky ball, they say. It was touched, says Tim Higgins. Tipped by Stanford.
And here is a case where Padgett tried to finish this off with the dunk. I don't agree with that call, Jim. The ball was released, hits the rim, and then I think it was touched. Check me on this one. Boom. See, the ball hit the rim. I don't think it ever touched the Stanford hand. I think that should have been Stanford's ball.
A full timeout called by Kentucky.
Take a look at it. This is a better angle. I don't think a Stanford hand ever touched the ball. I think that this basket should have counted, and I'll tell you why. Here's the ball inside the basket, and the hand is in the cylinder. You can see it right there. Now, it's either 2 points Kentucky, or it is Stanford ball, because the last person to touch it is Padgett, without question. But we've looked at it 18 times during a commercial in slow motion, so give the guys in a striped shirt some credit.
Super slow-mo.
Super slow-mo, yeah.
One full timeout for Stanford, two full ones for Kentucky, and Kentucky with possession. 131 remaining in overtime.
Solid screen. Collins steps out.
Shepard loves the shot. And again, he delivers.
Is he amazing coming off that curl, whether it be coming off to the right or the left? He squares up perfectly.
82-78. A career high for Shepard. 26 points. Weems comes off a pick, fires back a three of his own. Collins with the rebound. Somebody was holding.
Padgett was pulling him down.
Collins, the freshman, to the line for two.
And young players that are watching, watch how Shepard comes out. See how he squares up his feet even though he's coming against his body for that jump shot. That's why the shot is square, and that's why he doesn't glide to the right or the left. He turns that lead foot in square to the basket, which brings his whole body then square around, including his shoulders. Terrific curl move shooter.
Minute three to go, two for Collins. His first four free throws in this game. He's clanked the last two.
Still plenty of time, Jim.
3-point game. A minute to go. Stanford came back from four down with a minute to play in regulation. And Madsen on the reach in.
Not a bad foul right here. Remember who's going to the line. Turner. He's had his problems there.
Only problem for the Stanford side. That's the fourth on Madsen. If somehow this game was to go an extra 5 minutes after this one.
So you think you're back at Clemson, Minnesota, huh?
Double overtime in this building. It has been.
I will say something, and not trying to look ahead for either one of these ball clubs, but a game that is as physical as this that goes into an overtime makes a lot out of you for the next game.
Two for Turner.
Only a 56% free throw shooter his first two seasons.
Four-point lead, 53 seconds.
You can take a two or a three here. You don't have to settle on a three. You got two-possession game.
Brian Mendez with a three. Comes home to Texas. Brings his team to within one. And they put Turner right back on the line. Lee knows it. Turner will go back for two attempts.
Very good.
good strategy right there by Mike Montgomery. Now, remember last weekend, Jim, we saw such great coaching performances. Tubby Smith with a great comeback against Duke. Mike Montgomery extending that game against Rhode Island. He's doing the same thing right here. You try to take a minute ball game and turn it into a five-minute game.
Young son John, daughter Annie Montgomery, two shots for Turner.
Look good. Figure a young man who scored 62 in a high school game would have a hard time from the foul line, do you?
Nope. The kid who hit the three at the other end, though, scored 71 once in a high school game, but never a bigger basket than that one by Mendez. Here's the second one. Got him both. Turner with three in a row from the line.
But it still is a one-possession game with a three-point lead.
McGlure inserted for Muhammad.
And again, the defensive pressure of McGlure, the shot blocker down inside.
42 seconds.
And still enough time not to have to rely strictly on the three-point shot.
They seem to like to take the three in this situation. Lee got in regulation. Mendez already hit one. Can he do it again? Nope. Long rebound to Madsen, though. Weems is waiting for it. No pass his way. 24 seconds. Weems to tie. Off the glass. Tipped out again to Madsen. Lee rejected, and out to Shepard. He was fouled.
And give Tubby Smith some credit. The substitution of McGlure in for Nazi Muhammad. The defensive shot block. That's it on the floor, but great hustle. There it is. Tubby Smith making all the right moves.
And Madsen fouls out with 9 points, 16 rebounds.
So you have Young and Madsen out. But, Jim, looking up at the scoreboard, that shouldn't hurt them at all because they've got to go to the three-point shot now the rest of the way.
Mr. Madsen watches as Sauer comes in. And Shepard to the line for two with 15 seconds to go. Already with a career-high 26. Ooh,
big.
To make it a two-possession game. Timeout, Kentucky. A 20. They call a 20. Now it's a full. Tubby said he wanted a 20, but they only have a full. So it's a full extension. Stanford down four, 15 seconds to go in overtime. San Antonio. And a timeout situation, one full timeout for each team. Kentucky with another second half comeback here. 17 down in the second half, the regional final to Duke. Back to win it for the Wildcats. 10 down in the second half to Stanford today.
A lot of confidence in his team, and you can see that Tubby Smith in his timeout patterns, Jim, loves to call and set his team in place. Now, there's two philosophies there. Some coaches say, hey, when I've got the lead, I don't want to give that other guy a chance to set up. Tubby Smith, of the principal, he always wants his club to know exactly what he wants them to do.
Now, Stanford, four down with 15 seconds, and you got to go full court here. What do you do?
Well, you've got a two-possession game, Jim, so I think that you get satisfied to go and get the two as opposed to taking the wild three. This is Stanford, a school that in the school year 97 won six NCAA team championships, beating their all-time record of five in both 95 and 96.
Inbounds to McDonald, freshman.
Take it to the basket.
Sauer plants the feet. 3 points. Oh, 1 point game, 9 seconds to go.
The captain,
bad wheel and all.
Yeah, he was going at the right speed with that bad knee to be in perfect position to be open. McDonald wasn't sure what he wanted to do with it. And here is the delayed break by Sauer. Perfect release.
It may have been Sauer, but it's down to one.
Sweet.
Yeah, you got it. Shepard's on the floor. Magic Turner is in there. Edwards also. Padgett.
Well, you can see Mills, 95% free throw shooter. Turner is going to break through the ball. If you're Kentucky, you would think you'd want Cameron Mills breaking through the ball and let him get fouled.
Edwards will inbound. They will not man the inbounds pass.
Right, Stanford looking to try to pick up the first cutter through with Sauer.
They made a steal in the Rhode Island game in this situation. They tie up Padgett. The arrow belongs to Kentucky. The arrow belongs to Kentucky. Kentucky ball.
And there is the controversial rule of why does the defense get penalized by the arrow with a great defensive play.
6 seconds to go. Edwards calls the last timeout for Kentucky. Wow. 6 seconds on the clock. Kentucky leads by one in overtime. We'll be right
back. Two free throws are down three. Obviously, they've got to go for a three-point shot. Otherwise, they can tie it for two. Or win with two if he doesn't make any of them.
Sauer, Mendez, freshman Jaron Collins, Chris Weems, and Arthur Lee on the floor for Stanford. Kentucky counters with Mills, Edwards, Padgett, Turner, and Shepard.
Coming up in the next game, we have North Carolina. They won a national championship in 57 with two games which they played triple overtime. Is Kentucky working on that? Or Stanford? And Kentucky looks like they might want to break a guy long on a solid screen here.
This time they man the inbounds pass. Edwards needs help. Goes long, and Turner gets it. They must foul him quickly. They do with 2.5 to go.
Boy, and Lee thought he had picked that off. Turner just beat him. Like two guys going out for a pass in the end zone. A great defender against a good wide receiver. Wide receiver comes up with it.
I'll tell you, had he even picked it off, though, he would have been going in the wrong direction. It would have been hard for him to even get back. Fire a pass, plant yourself.
Good job by Turner to kind of tap that over to himself. Wasted another probably half a second.
All right, Turner's made his last three attempts. He'll shoot two. Wild on the first one.
So they do have a shot, Jim.
And they bring in the shot blocker, McGlure.
Out goes Mills. So they're big now.
2.5 seconds to go.
Not enough time to dribble the ball the length of the court. You got to make a throw for a jump shot on the side.
Who will play Monday night?
Long.
Rebound, Sauer.
He's got a
Sauer. Needs some help. Wildly throws it long. Kentucky advances. What a game. Kentucky in overtime. 86-85. Kentucky, for the third straight year, will play in the national championship game. Kentucky won in 96, lost in the final last year, but will be in San Antonio on